What does CAGR mean? How do I use CAGR in financial analysis? How to calculate CAGR? What is the formula for CAGR in Excel? All of these questions about CAGR will be answered in this video. CAGR is often found in the financial news, more specifically in merger and acquisition announcements, as well as investor presentations where a longer term perspective is taken than just the current year. You might find a CEO or CFO talking about the CAGR of the attractive markets the company competes in, the commitment the company makes on the CAGR of its revenue, and the resulting CAGR in earnings. What is important to understand is that CAGR is never standalone. It is always the CAGR of something. CAGR of estimated market size, CAGR of revenue, CAGR of earnings per share. Very often, CAGR is applied to a 3-year or 5-year period to zoom out to the bigger picture of the historical financial performance of a company or its expected future performance. What does the acronym CAGR stand for? CAGR, sometimes pronounced as CAGR, is compound annual growth rate. If you look up the textbook definition of CAGR, it will tell you that CAGR is a geometric progression rate that provides a constant rate of return over the time period. Personally, that doesn't tell me much yet. Let's park that CAGR definition for later use. Let's first go to the very basics of CAGR to start understanding what it means, how to calculate it, and how to use it, and then return to the CAGR definition later on. To understand CAGR, you first need to understand the idea of compound growth. Let's look at the company's outlook based on today's sales number of $100 million and an expected growth rate of those sales. We make the assumption that for each year in the next 5 years, sales will be 20% higher than the year before. What that equates to is, year one's estimated sales is $120, 20% growth on $100. Year two's estimated sales is $144, 27% growth on $120. Year 3's estimated sales is $173, 20% growth on $144. Year 4's estimated sales is $207, 20% growth on $173. And year 5's estimated sales is $249, 20% growth on $207. So the growth rate is constant at 20% growth per year, but the absolute amount of the year-over-year variance keeps increasing. That's what compound growth, or growth on top of growth, does. Here's where CAGR comes in. CAGR is the assumed constant rate of return over a time period, usually expressed as a percentage. While we have numbers for 6 years displayed in the overview, we take 5 incremental steps to get from starting point to ending point. If your year 0 sales was $100 million, your year 5 sales $249 million, then 20% year-over-year growth would get you from A to B. That is what CAGR does, which is wonderful. And it is all of what it does, which you have to be aware of. The risk in using CAGR is that people take constant rate of return too literally. CAGR does not give you visibility to what actually happens between the start point and end point. It assumes a constant growth rate, but does not guarantee it. For example, you might have a sales growth pattern that is slow at first and then picks up strongly from year 4 to year 5. Or you might have a sales growth pattern that is very strong from year 0 to year 1 and then flattens off. Or you might have enormous growth from year 0 to year 1 and then a decline in every year afterwards. CAGR does not care, and it is not designed to care. After all, CAGR is just a mathematical formula, and formulas are not supposed to have feelings. CAGR takes the starting point, in our example $100 million, the ending point, in our example $249 million, and the number of increments from start to end, in our example 5 steps, and returns a constant rate of return based on those variables. How to calculate CAGR? Let's derive CAGR mathematically first and then jump to calculating CAGR in Excel a little bit later. We know that in our example, the endpoint equals the starting point times 1 plus CAGR times 1 plus CAGR times 1 plus CAGR times 1 plus CAGR times 1 plus CAGR. If the abstract mathematics already overwhelm you, let's just plug the numbers in. The ending point of $249 million equals the starting point of $100 million times 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2. In other words, ending point equals starting point times 1 plus CAGR to the power n, where n is the number of years. We can move those terms around, swap what is on the left and what is on the right of the equal sign. We can then move the variable start point from left to right. Multiply on one side is equal to dividing on the other side. We then move the power sign from left to right. To the power n on one side is equal to the power 1 divided by n on the other side. And finally, we move the 1 from left to right and come up with CAGR equals ending point divided by starting point to the power 1 divided by n, and all of that minus 1. Let me show you the same formula in Excel for the numbers in our example. CAGR equals cell G2 divided by cell B2, ending point divided by starting point, to the power 1/5, and all of that minus 1. On the keyboard of my PC, that roof sign that is used for power is inserted into the formula by pressing Shift and 6. Remember, CAGR is not designed to care about the actual values of the intermediate steps, so whatever the value is in year 1, year 2, year 3 and year 4, based on this starting point and this ending point, the CAGR is 20%. An alternative way of calculating CAGR in Excel is to use the Excel function power, which returns the results of a number raised to a power. In the field number, you fill in the formula G2 divided by B2, and in the field power, you fill in 1/5. In summary, CAGR is compound annual growth rate, the geometric progression rate that provides a constant rate of return over the time period. I hope you enjoyed this explanation of the meaning of CAGR, how to calculate CAGR, and how to use CAGR to analyze a company's financial results. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up. On this end screen, there are a few suggestions of related videos you can watch next. Please subscribe to the Finance Storyteller YouTube channel. Thank you.